Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Well, it's been a big story this week. One of New Zealand's top private schools, St Kentigern's College, has been ousted from an Auckland Schoolboy Rugby Competition. They've been accused of poaching players from across the country. Now, 11 schools say they won't play St Kent's. So what does it mean for our Pacific players, especially when an opportunity comes knocking to get a scholarship to a private school? Joining me for today, for our Talanoa, is former All Black Pita Alatini. He's also a former player for the King's College First 15. And also yes. Former Manu Samoa captain and one of the most capped players for the Highlanders, of course, Mulitalo Filipo Levi. Thank you both for joining us on the program.
Thank you for having us.
Peter, you're down the road, of course, at Pakuranga. You weren't involved in all this St Kent's thing, were you?
No, not involved at all. Obviously, ex-King's College students, so I totally understand, I suppose, the pain that the other schools are having at the moment to play, but reality is it is a high-profile game now, high performance in that matter, especially in the First 15 competition in Auckland. So the challenges around that unfortunately does come with this criticism, and then that's what these schools have come to.
And it's not new, is it? I mean, it's been going on for many years, not just St Kent's, not just Auckland, not just...
Many years this has been happening within Auckland, and I think it's just come to an end where I suppose the challenging colleges have probably had enough and feel that they don't probably have the resources they need to challenge.
Filippo, what do you make of the situation?
I think it is an opportunity for students getting their scholarships, but also there's also an opportunity cost for those who are already there. So those students who have already worked, you know, been through the system at
the right
St Kent's, you know, you need to question, okay, is that person they're coming in, is it for the right reasons? Is it for the educational reasons? So you need to really look at the well-being of the person. If it's a Pacifica, Māori or whoever, you need to really look at the whole aspect of that person coming in. But, you know, I understand the schools, and I've worked with college sport before, and they have the bylaws. So they are working within the bylaws, but there's a moral issue here as well.
Yeah, and talking about that, I mean, of course, it's for the rugby team, but how much are these guys really looking after someone? You bring in someone in year 13, how much they care about the education? Are they being looked after enough?
Look, there's no studies, but I know some students have come through St Kent's to the club I coach at Marist, and I asked the question, "What? How's your education going?" And oh, okay, I'm doing okay. Rather than say, "Yeah, I'm doing well. I'm going to university. I'm doing a trades or something." It's not really.
It's really vague.
It's
really vague in terms of what they want to do. Obviously, they come from sports is going to be their main industry, but they seem to follow whatever else those before them have done, and they kind of think they're going through that course without kind of knowing exactly what it is.
Does there need to be some more guidelines to stop people being poached at that late? Should be people will only be offered 5-year scholarships, you know, and properly support our students?
Yeah, I think I was talking to mother the other day at Barford Thompson that just said that there's no 4A team from St Kent, so meaning there's no teams in the year 11 from St Kent's. That was quite interesting. So there's no sort of system that's going through from year 9 to year 13, where some schools like, say, St Peter's, most of those students will go through.
You're right, and there's that proper development right throughout the school years, and that's the other thing that's a big problem. A lot of our low decile schools, now they're missing out on their top players being picked away.
Correct. I think the hurt from most of these schools are that they've nurtured this kid from third form, or year 9, sorry, third form back in our day, but all the way to year 12 or year 11, and then these other schools are seeing this talent and taking probably what's their best within that group, which they've built their team around, and taking it to a school which, at the end of the day, again, more resources and other opportunities for them to go through.
So, but isn't this just the reality of professional sport? We're actually offering kids that just at a younger level what's actually happening in the real world.
I think it's a concern if we focus on their high performance at a certain age. You know, you'll have a sort of peak and they sort of come off at a certain age because they won't get the support when they leave first 15 rugby into club comp, club competition. You know, you need to really work really hard.
Another thing, you don't just get an opportunity to fast-track your career into professional rugby by going over to an elite college. You know,
correct.
Plenty of top sports guys have come out of...
Correct. I'd say these studies there with kids that have come out of school playing that top rugby for 3 years that haven't quite cracked it and actually have given up the game just because I think they're burnt out and haven't really had the support.
I've had a chat to Issa. Issa Nadewa, and he was in the third 15 at the Grammar, Auckland Grammar.
Okay.
You know, and he's come through now to be the most successful Leinster captain in Europe, you know.
Any of the examples. We've got to almost wrap up. What kind of mechanisms do need to be put in place to stop this thing happening?
that's probably the hardest question out, knowing that where all these principles lie. I think at the end of the day, all these principals, I suppose it's around their schools they're always trying to look after. So it's you know, so for them, some of them, I think it's an ego thing as well. We probably have to pull back a bit and think about what we are really pushing towards our kids going in the future, especially where they're going to. And remember, it's not just rugby that's getting scholarships. There's different other sports and education pathways for everyone. Yeah, so exactly. It is tough.
Thank you both for coming on the show. Really enjoyed our chat.
Maru, thank you. Okay.